So, between Station 19 and Gray's, we've seen Miranda and Ben's relationship hit this tipping point, and the sabbatical, and your character...
The sabbatical.
I know, it's so office-like.
It's like,
yeah,
capital,
you know?
Letters with quotes around it, the sabbatical.
So your character's moved out. What did you think of this storyline when you first read it?
It's, you know, look, you have mixed feelings, because as a fan of the show, and I was a fan of Grey's long before I was ever on it, my lady got me watching it, and she was like, you need to check this show out, and I was like, I want to be on that show someday, and then I was a couple years later. And I love this Ben-Bailey relationship. I always have from day one. So I want to see Ben and Bailey together and happy as a fan of the show, but I also, I'm a military kid. My dad was in the Navy, and I love that we're telling the story of how hard it is for the families of first responders and military people, people who put their lives on the line for other people. I love that they're telling the story of how hard it is. So it's a, I love that they're telling the story, but at the same time, I don't want them to have problems.
It's like, don't let mom and dad break up.
Yeah,
don't
break them up. And it's going to be interesting to see how, because you know she swears it's just a sabbatical, it's not a divorce, and he's convinced this is the first step to divorce.
And how do you know how long this storyline, this arc, is going to last? Is this through the whole rest of the season?
I'll let you know when I know.
Okay. So when the writers came up with this, did they say this is an effort to give some separation between the two shows, or?
No. In fact, it's funny because you know, when they said there was going to be a spinoff of Grey's Anatomy, everybody starts reading the tea leaves to figure out what's the spinoff going to be about and who's going to be on it. And because I love this relationship, I always thought this was the relationship was one of the reasons why I wouldn't be on the spinoff. And it turns out it's actually the thing they loved most about me being on the spinoff was it's part of the connective tissue between Grey's Anatomy and Station 19. That hasn't changed because, you know, even if Ben and Bailey aren't together, how interesting is it to see, you know, people who have such history have to deal with each other, because I'm going to bring patients up to that hospital. And she's going to come out to collect patients from, you know, the firefighter paramedics. So we're going to have to deal with each other whether we're together or not. So I don't think it's in any way separating the two shows. I think it's just, you know, at the end of the day, we all want our friends on TV to be happy, but, sure, you know, happy couples aren't fun TV. You know, drama. They got to bring in some drama.
I mean, that goodbye kiss was a doozy.
Yeah.
I mean, so there's obviously still passion there, but the passion is sort of the problem for Bailey.
Exactly. Look, the passion never goes away. I mean, that's the thing is, you know, I think she's pretty clear in saying that she, you know, she loves Ben. She just feels like, you know, this situation is breaking her heart. And so he just wanted to make sure, I think that last kiss was Ben stamped to just be like, just so we're clear, this right here is out there.
Yeah.
You're pushing it out the door. That's, you know, and so that was a fun thing to play.
Yeah. Yeah. And I mean, do you want to see your characters date other people? How do you feel about that?
Wow. Oh, okay.
You know,
oh,
opening that door. Like, I mean, that's kind of a whole new exciting thing.
Do I want to see? It's interesting and it's exciting. I only, I want to see the most interesting things happen for the show. I always want to be entertained as a fan. I mean, when we do table reads for me, that's when I get to watch the show just purely as a fan. And then I got to actually go perform it. So, that's even weird. I mean, you said, talk about Ben with other folks, and that trips me out. But that is a real possibility, I guess, right?
It would be now, right? I guess it depends on how they handle the separation.
You know, even weirder would be seeing Bailey with somebody else. Yeah, Ben would not be down. Ben
There's always some new hot residents coming in.
You know, Ben, look, you know, Ben is a very calm dude, but I'm pretty certain he would go off on something. Like, you know, there'd be a conversation.
Oh, yeah.
And be like, yeah, that's my lady. I know we're not together right now, but you go near her, you and me got a problem.
Well, some people have been a little critical on Facebook, like, okay, well, Bailey handles all these surgeries and everything, but she can't handle him being a firefighter. But what's your take on that?
Well, I'm like, you know, again, I got to defend my girl.
Yeah.
Because you mess up in surgery and the patient dies, you know, and your career has problems. You mess up as a firefighter and you die. The victim dies. Other firefighters die. It's the stakes go through the roof for you personally, in a way that isn't the case when you're in a nice sterile ER, you know, in a nice, you know, sterile operating room. So I got to ask people to give her a little bit of slack on that. That, you know, it is a different level of stress, and you have to acknowledge that.
It's been interesting seeing the storyline play out between the two shows, because you really do have to watch both to understand all the problems in the relationship and what's been going on.
But that's what's dope. I love the fact that it's, you know, it's genuinely a, you know, a Grey's Anatomy universe. You know, I mean, not everybody's got to have a universe now. But it, what I love about it is that there are things happening on Station 19 that will come into Grey's Anatomy and vice versa. And you don't need to know all about it to still enjoy Grey's Anatomy or enjoy Station 19. But it definitely helps. And it's just that little breadcrumb of curiosity to come see what's up. And yeah, and the fact that other characters besides Ben are starting to have relationships and talk with people across. You know, when Meredith Grey sees, you know, Andy Hedetta and they say, oh, hey, how you been? You know, that they have a relationship. That's cool to see. And so I love that that it's a genuine world.
Mm-hmm. Are there any guest stars you'd like to see join your show that you haven't had yet?
Look, I want to see, you know, my greatest family, that's still home. So, you know, there's a home that you grow up in and there's a home that you help build. Like, mm-hmm. I would love to see, you know, I love when Ellen comes over. I would love to see Jesse come over. You know, Kelly's already come over. You know, that's already aired in Giacomo. Mm-hmm. Jannetty's come over. You know, people have seen that already. So I can't tell you who's already come to play. But yeah, but the fun part is that there's always going to be a back and forth because, you know, again, you know, it's becoming more like a real place because it's a world.
Any complete outsiders that we could set the stage for, that maybe we could plant the seed in their mind?
Well,
to
I mean,
come
you
over?
Guys already got a taste with Dermot Mulroney coming through playing Ryan's dad, which, by the way, we all tripped out when they announced that, because you want to talk about before and after pictures. Like, Dermot Mulroney looks like, you know, Alberto. Like, they look. Like, I'm like, I believe he's your dad, just from the face. We did photos and we had him around set of, like, you know, their faces together, and they're great together.
That's so funny.
So I want to see more like that.
Okay. And you know, would you ever go back to Grey's? Would there ever be any talk of, like, you know, seasons in, let's say years down the road, and Grey's is still happening? Would you give up being a firefighter to go back to being a doctor again?
I don't know. I mean, look, I love Grey's and I would go back there in a heartbeat, but I like the action. You know, but, you know, I mean, firefighters get hurt and Ben has a better backup gig than most. So if he ever got injured in a way that, you know, he can't make it up the stairs and carry, you know, a 200-pound man out of a burning house, then if the hands are still good, you go back into surgery.
Anything else you can preview for us coming up this season?
I will say that the Ben and Bailey situation, I mean, it's at a head now, and I truly enjoyed having to, because, you know, Ben is thrown. Ben's on the ropes on this one because he didn't see it coming. Mm-hmm. He knew it bothered her, but he didn't see it coming. So for me, getting to go there and the stories that they tell there are I think are going to be a fun journey for fans of the show to watch.
Well, thanks for taking the time to speak with me about all this. This is great.
Oh, thank you.